Hi guys, so today I have a Mercedes over. She's one of my models that I shot before and love shooting in general. And we're here to interview Mercedes and to ask her about a couple of questions about her career, which is very successful. So hi Mercedes.
Hi.
So excited to have you over.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So first of all, I remember when we first shot together.
Yes.
You were obviously very beautiful and successful all the time. But you were like at 20K or something, right? On Instagram when we met.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, you became so popular on Instagram and TikTok. So can you just elaborate a little bit about like how did you get there?
Sure, yes. So I downloaded TikTok in COVID times because I was bored. And to be honest, I just did dancing videos, and one of them were like super trending and went viral like overnight, like 100 million views. And that gave me like a boost for my Instagram, and then whatsoever like opened so many doors. I got invited to Los Angeles after, and then just to like work for like people, like collaborations and whatsoever. So it started from like one video, to be honest, and then after everything just like followed each other, you know what I mean? Like I made more videos, and then my Instagram got bigger and bigger and bigger, and I'm like, oh my god, that's a lot of people. Like,
right.
Yeah, I was very surprised in a way, because it was such a stupid video. I don't know if you've seen that, but it was just like literally dancing for like a Japanese song, and people liked it and tend to like it because they still follow. And
right.
Now I have 1.7 million on one account, and then a million on another one. That's like a backup account, and yeah.
Well, people seem to like you, obviously, because
it's amazing. I'm very grateful, and I enjoy doing TikToks and photos as well. Like,
right?
Yeah, but TikTok was the push, I feel like, for my Instagram.
Right.
Yeah.
So did it happen just overnight, or how does it? Because I know a lot of girls are trying to get viral and all this. Do you have some tips on how to get viral on TikTok?
Yeah, absolutely. Because after that, I started to like watch what makes a video go viral, right? Mm-hmm. Because when you get the rush, you want to like do it again. Like, oh, I want to be on the For You page again. I want to be like famous again. So what I started to do is like I checked the sounds under the videos. That's one of the main things.
Mm-hmm.
Don't use hashtags, actually, because so many people like hashtag For You page and stuff like that, and that doesn't matter. Like, For You page, they're saying, is a myth. Like, you're gonna get end up eventually in the For You page because you post a video, where it's gonna go on the For You page.
Right.
So I think you have to find a niche, and the very important part is the first 5 seconds of a video. You have to like grab the attention.
Right.
So you have to do like a movement or like a face or like just like what I do usually is like this, like stop, you know, like stop scrolling, because then and I start my dance, because the first 5 seconds counts as a view. So you have to really grab the attention first, and then after what you do, doesn't matter. They're going to watch it anyways.
Right.
So those are, I think, the components combined together makes a video go viral. And obviously, I think the quality too, but it's like another like 10%, you know, and then details like that, like the outfits, makeup, like
the whole picture has to look good.
The whole picture has to look good, and you have to do the dance on the rhythm, but those are like very detailed stuff. And I tested out for like months before, because once I got the video viral, I was like, wow, like I wonder why it went viral, because it was like no sense, you know, like such a stupid dance. And
how does it work? So you go viral with one video, and then all the rest of the videos get viral too, or how's the algorithm work?
So for example, the 100 million views video, after that you get the followers, obviously, and you get like a base of people who's gonna start to follow you, and then they're gonna watch your rest of your video. But if they are like different topics or themes, they tend to unfollow you because they follow you for one niche.
Right.
So if I do dancing videos, I keep dancing, so they're gonna follow me and remember me as like, oh, that's the girl who like dancing in cute outfits. But if I switch up and I do cooking videos, they're gonna unfollow because that's not the reason I got their interest, right?
Right.
So I think it's very important, if you open an account, you stick to your topic and you just follow that.
So I of course follow you, and I've noticed that you have were invited to Netflix and some acting career as well.
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about this one.
So for acting, it was like very something I started next to university because it was, you know, an easy cash job. I started off as a background extra. I signed up with a couple agencies and I got upgraded. I got like speaking roles in a show. And then after that, when I joined the union, it was like much easier to get into shows because obviously you have like a portfolio already. So that just happened by accident. I never tend to be to work for like Netflix or Amazon or like bigger shows like that, but it's obviously it's a good money, it's a good job, I like to do it. And I was 2 days ago standing like a body double for like a famous lady, and we did that for 3 weeks. And yeah, I'm trying to like get to the speaking roles point, but to be honest with you, I don't know if I want to do that. Like, right. I don't feel like inside I would be like a great actress or I'm more into social media, to be honest, and TikTok and pictures like that.
Right.
Yeah. As an actress, I don't know if I see myself, you know, like I heard success stories that TikTokers get like movies, video mm-hmm. clips, singers, like it doesn't really matter because if you have the clout and the followers, you can do anything, right? So, yeah, but personally, I would stay with social media.
Yeah. So I know you have the My OnlyFans account.
Yeah.
I've heard that they're like they want to turn it down or something for nudes.
Yes.
Is that true?
No.
What are the rumors about this?
So they were saying that they're gonna ban nudity,
mm-hmm.
like, and they try to make it more mainstream to have people subscribe because they want to see you like working out videos, cooking videos, like what's like whatever, like YouTube, right?
Mm-hmm.
To subscribe, and I think it failed because. Honestly, I think it was a publicity stunt. Like, they did this for, oh, everybody talked about it, and they got the clout again, right?
Right.
So it was a very smart move, and then when they saw that everybody was, like, reacting in a negative way, they
mm-hmm.
just took it back. So everything is the same.
Okay, so they don't actually ban it?
No.
Okay, well, no, that's good.
It's good. It's just, they, you know, they don't tolerate anything involved, like, blood or like stuff like that, like
yes.
super, you know, like dark things, and then obviously it's gonna be like banned, but everything is the same.
For sure. So I, as I said to you before, one of the things that I do appreciate about you is that you became famous, but you are still like this nice
Aww,
person,
thank
and
you.
You're so great, one of the nicest people I know.
Thank you.
So that's really good, and I'm sure you're gonna take it that way throughout your life.
I will, for sure, yeah. Because I think you have to give the respect to everyone, and because you get like famous or something, that shouldn't change your personality. Because I don't forget the people who were there when I had 20,000 followers. You know what I mean? Like, if those people worked with me and they liked me and they are stick to me, like, I'm gonna be working with them if I'm famous too. So it shouldn't be like you forget those people.
Right.
Yeah.
So I know you have obviously a pretty face and a pretty body, but I know that. There is a story behind it, and I know there is some personal story that you shared with me, and I think our followers would love to hear that as well.
Yes, so I wasn't always beautiful or pretty. I had plastic surgeries such as like boob jobs and a nose job. Other than that, I had a hard time to fit in high school because I was more, you know, chubby, and you just...
You were chubby?
Yeah.
I can't believe that.
No, I was like fat, like big. And then, you know, it's like Eastern Europe, it's like a pressure that you want to like fit in, you want to be tall, skinny,
mm-hmm.
you know, like beautiful hair, nice eyes, and you just want to look like them. So I was not that. But yeah, I went through like depression because of that, and I developed bulimia at some point because I just wanted to fit in, I guess. And that was like all before social media. So that genuinely came from a place where I just wanted to look like those people who were like famous in my
right.
high school. So, but when you're 15, 16, you know what I mean? Like, I think almost everybody goes through that. But I did end up in hospital, and it was a dark 3 years to come out of that. But after it was done, I found like my inner peace. And I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna do my thing. I'm not gonna compare myself to others because that's not me. Like, I'm never gonna be that. I did the boobs and the nose because I wanted to, not because I wanted to look like someone.
Always people, when they see like a pretty face and a perfect picture, they don't know like what stands behind it, right?
Exactly.
And there is, first of all, the soul of the person who became that person, right? And the things that took him to get there.
Yeah.
And I know you told me that you raised your sister by yourself.
Yeah.
So this is something that I want people to like actually notice, accept like the beautiful face and everything, and I'm sure you do as well. So tell me a little bit about that. Like, I know there is like a lot of pain there in raising your sister by yourself.
Yeah, it was a hard time because, you know, my mom, she divorced my dad when we were kids, and then she had to work a lot. So I raised my sister when we were like, she was 10, I was 14. So I went to school with like being a mom, like learning how to cook, you know, like washing clothes. I had no idea. I was like grade 7, 8, and I was like, oh my God, I didn't know what is a Tide Pod. So that was challenging, but I feel like it added so much to my personality. That's why I was like always a little bit more mature than my age, because I raised a kid. So in the time, like, my mom used to like send us money and then that's it. Like, we had to do the groceries, we had to cook, we had to do everything. And it was very hard when you wanted to like do things for yourself, and then there was another like person who you had to take care of. And when you're a kid, it's, you know, taking care of as a kid, it's like a pressure.
Mm-hmm.
So I think I did well. I got through that period, and it was very painful. It was very hard because, you know, my grades were like going down. I didn't study because I was more busy with my sister. So I kind of like sacrificed a little from my time and myself to raise my sister, because my mom had to work. Like, it wasn't from, you know, because she didn't care. She was just working so much to like make it more livable for us and pay rent and then bills and two kids.
For sure.
Yeah,
for sure.
It was hard, yeah. But the connection is definitely stronger between us because of that. Like, we never had this sister sibling feeling. We had always like very like motherly feeling towards her, because,
right,
you know what I mean? Like, everything is good now, you know. My mom remarried, she's happy, she's living in the suburbs in Hungary, and yeah, I came by myself here, to be honest, and yeah, everything is good. I just worked my way, you know.
I have a present for you.
Oh.
This is my appreciation for you too, for coming by.
You shouldn't.
And I hope you're gonna like it.
Oh no, I'm nervous. Really?
Okay, so this is our photo from...
No way!
Our first photo shoot from...
That was the first one. Holy!
Yeah, so I hope you're gonna enjoy it. It's definitely...
Wait, that's mine?
Yes, this is gonna go to your home. And...
Oh my goodness! That's beautiful. Come on.
So it's from my exhibition that we've had lately, and the sponsors, the guys that printed the photo, Addictive Things. So we decided to give it for you as a gift.
That's
so
insane.
You are welcome to have it after we're done.
Thank you.
And
oh my goodness, are you serious?
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
It was so great to have you over.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. And I wish you the best of luck with all the shows and everything. Thank you.